In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Good Shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Stir up your power, O Lord, and come to our help with mighty strength, that what our sins impede, the grace of your mercy may hasten. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On that day, they will sing this song in the land of Judah. A strong city have we. He sets up walls and ramparts to protect us. Open up the gates to let in a nation that is just, one that keeps faith. A nation of firm purpose you keep in peace. In peace, for its trust in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord is an eternal rock. He humbles those in high places, and the lofty city he brings down. He tumbles it to the ground, levels it with the dust. It is trampled underfoot by the needy, by the footsteps of the poor. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Open to me the gates of justice. I will enter them and give thanks to the Lord. This gate is the Lord's. The just will enter it. I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have been my Savior.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
O Lord, grant salvation. O Lord, grant prosperity. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Please stand.
Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. Everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house. But it did not collapse. It had been set solidly on rock. And everyone who listens to these words of mine but does not act on them will be like a fool who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, and it collapsed and was completely ruined." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Year 2013, when the whole of this cathedral underwent some serious structural evaluation and construction. Sinilip po muli yung tibay at tatag ng lupa at ng buong katedral para makatayo pa po ang katedral natin sa mas madaming mga panahon at taon. There were retrofittings, they call, foundation checking, and etc. Mga bagay para malaman ang katibayan at tumayong matibay ang ating pong inang simbahan. My dear brothers and sisters, what seems to be common with today's readings will be the symbol of rock. Hindi lang dahil ang bato ay matigas, pero ito ay simbolo ng katibayan. And maybe you'll ask, what will be its use as we are celebrating Advent? What will be its use or help as we prepare for Christmas? I know one thing for sure. Sa Diyos tayo kukuha ng katibayan. Because the Lord is our rock, we will endure. In the first reading, God placed walls and ramparts, strong defenses, so that God will be able to protect His people, para matibay na bantayan ng Diyos ang kanyang bayan. In the same manner, Jesus teaches us to listen and do His words so that we will be strong and so that we can endure life. Kaya anuman ang humampas sa atin, anuman ang humagupit sa atin, anuman ang gustong sumira sa atin, matibay tayong tatayo, mananatili tayong nakatayo dahil sa Diyos. Because God is our rock, we may not only be strong, but we can also endure. Hindi lang matigas, kundi matibay. If we've been battling, if life is swaying us from left to right, if we are doubting, if we are struggling, remember that the Lord is rock. He would not only make you hard, but He will help you endure. Mga kapatid, ang gusto po ng Diyos, matibay at malakas tayo. Matibay at malakas, nayayakapin ang mga biyaya ng Pasko. Whatever may come across, we will stand tall, we will stand strong, we will endure, not because we can, but because God is our rock.
Please stand.
Confident that He will grant us what we ask for, we make our prayer to God the Father with a sincere heart. For every petition we shall say, Loving Father, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That the Pope, bishops, priests, and religious may be faithful to their commitment to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That politicians and all those who serve in government may be faithful to their promises and obligations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That our faith may find solid ground in our examples rather than in our words. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That all of us who handle duties and responsibilities may carry out our tasks efficiently. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
That our departed relatives and friends may finally receive their heavenly reward. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions as we lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass as we also pray for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
Father, you are our strength in time of need. Open our hearts to your grace and lead us into your kingdom. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, the Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer the prayer Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Not a mass of
Please stand.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For our regular Mass goers, as you can see, the cathedral is prepared for an event or an ordination at 9 this morning. I ask you to please include in your prayers our three brothers who will be ordained as deacons, seminarians Marion, Richard, and Erwin, and one candidate for ordination, Reverend E.J. San Diego. Please do keep them in your prayers, and all of us priests and ministers of the church, that we may be faithful in our mission and vocation. And let us also pray that many young men and women may heed to the call of the priesthood and the religious life. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Inap na ang Diyos, ipinapiwalang sa lahat.